One, two, okay. Dear colleagues, I'm glad to say that our conference is opening. This conference, it is unicum because 12 conference before was only using only Russian language. In this conference, we tried to use English and language. All materials of poster presentation and oral presentation should be in English, but for speaker can use Russian language. Next year we will use only English. I hope it will be. Okay. I can try say more power. Okay. During the conference, competition for young scientists carried out, and for recognize the participant of this competition. Poster will be marked by these young birds. It is chicken. It is not angry birds. It is young chicken. Speaker of oral presentation should be do this. Okay, some important informations. If participate in the excursion to Kronstadt and resource centers of St. Petersburg State University, please say this information in reception registration. Next information: participations who does not live in Baltics or Burevestnik, please go to the registration and say about we clarify the we will manage the lunch for you. Okay, something forgot to say. Important information. Also, important things, maybe. Our program is slightly currently changed, and the correct program put in the desk, in the information desk. And now I would like to give microphone for continue of conference, Vladimir Ivanovich Chizhik.
Thank you very much. Dear colleagues, good morning, and I wish you successful work during our conference. And my first talk will be about the personality, great personality of Erwin Hahn. 2 months ago, I received the information about his death, and it's very sad event, and I'd like to pronounce a few words about this great personality. This information that on the 20th of September he died. It was the prominent American physicist, and you know this name very well. And but I think I can pronounce a few additional words about this personality. And the most success of Erwin Hahn was connected with discovering of the spin echo. I'd like to pronounce a few words about the phenomena of spin echo. Most of us know this very well, but just in case, I'd like to pronounce a few words, and maybe some information will be useful for following discussions. I'd like to remind you that in the rotating frame, nuclei feel so-called effective magnetic field, which is determined by such equation B sub 1. This is amplitude of alternating magnetic field, and additional term is the difference between resonance frequency and frequency of our additional alternating field. So if we use the condition delta omega is equal to zero, this term can be vanished, and we have such situation. This is the direction of the main field, static magnetic field. As usual, Z is along this field. And then this is rotating, rotation of frame. And we have, for example, the direction of B sub 1 in this direction. So the equilibrium of magnetization microscopy is along the field B sub 0. And we consider such situation. For example, this is our sample. And mentally, we divide this sample into many small parts. For example, 1 million parts. But in any case, these parts can be characterized by macroscopic magnetization. And the total magnetization is the sum of these separate magnetizations. And we consider, first, due to the inhomogeneity of the magnetic field, the frequency in each part will be different. It is omega sub I. So we have one meaning of magnetic field in one of pieces, omega sub zero, but it, this frequency slightly differ in other parts of the sample. But if we have a condition amplitude B sub 1 much more than delta omega divided gamma, we can neglect the difference during the pulse. So we consider, for example, only three M sub I, and I three, one, two, three, and our pulse directs this vectors in the position perpendicular to the B sub zero. And after this, we have such situation, this rotating frame. One of these vectors will be in the direction, for example, this X and Y, along the Y, but one of them will be moved in this direction, and the second in the opposite. So in this case, we have omega sub y more than omega sub zero, and in another vector, we have the situation that the omega sub I is less than omega sub zero. So these vectors will be moved in the different directions, and we have after 90 degrees pulse decrease of the free induction decay at this time. So if all frequency will be equal, we receive the decrease in accordance with the relaxation rate, theta. But if we apply the second pulse, which move these vectors in this direction, we receive such situation. First, in this position, this pulse in this magnetization, and this magnetization in this position, for example. And they move in the same direction. So after some time, these vectors again will be in the single direction, and we receive increase the signal after which is called spin echo. Now I'd like to show you this situation. This 90 degree pulse, and then disperse of the magnetization, then second pulse, and then we receive the spin echo. And then again the phasing of these vectors. One more, and then we continue. The second pulse 180, and then again coherence of yes. I met Professor Hahn a few times in during my life, and the first was in 1963. But I'd like, for beginning, to relate some interesting story. In 1988, very interesting conference was organized in Novosibirsk, and Erwin Hahn was invited to this conference, and it was very interesting to meet him. And at the conference dinner, I was sitting at the same table as Erwin Hahn, and I asked him, I think that you discovered Spinoza occasionally, really? And he answered yes, but in another manner than I thought. I thought that in that time electronics was not very good, and Professor Hahn investigated the signals after single pulse, free induction decay. And I thought that sometimes electronics produce not one pulse, but two pulses. And he saw spin echo. But it was another story. This is napkin from the table, small sheet of paper, and Erwin Hahn began his story, that he investigated such NMR signals. This is scope, screen of oscilloscope. He applied long pulse, during which he observed the signal, so-called fast adiabatical passage. You know maybe this man, but it's not very important. He observed observed in the times signals when B sub 1 is constant and during long time, and to observe the signal it is necessary, it is necessary to modulate a static field. And he applied modulation of the B sub zero. And after first experiment, he observed another signal after a certain time. And in the first step of experiment, he destroyed the magnetization, and after some time he can observe a new signal, but this amplitude depends on the T1. We should wait new magnetization after distortion in the first experiment. But once he forgot to switch modulation, and he saw first signal, second signal, and then he discovered new signal. Then he told that, then I decrease I decrease the length of the pulses both, and then this signal became larger. And this was the first observation of spin echo. And I asked him to give autograph. This is autograph of Erwin. And after this story, he began about such experiments, and even published similar pictures, but in more certainly accurate manner. This first signal, and then several signals which was received at different time intervals between first and second pulse. And this is the first publication of signal echo, and then more fine picture. This is interference between free induction decay and echo, because his pulses were in incoherence. This is equipment which Hahn used for this experiment. And this is first publication in 1950 in Physical Reviews. Very important. And it is interesting that I'll cite Hahn. He received a PhD degree in 1949, and he remained in a position postdoc in the Illinois University during a few years. And he worked in the group of Bloch, Felix Bloch. And then the citing. In the first edition of Charles Schlichter's book, Principles of Magnetic Resonance, it started that I discovered spin echo as a graduate student, but actually I was a postdoc. Because Charles' first book, I got the minor reputation of being a sort of wunderkind example as a gradient student. I had to explain that my thesis was not about the spin echo, and that is was discovered after I received my PhD. One more comment, this verse of Erwin Hahn. I was lucky to be familiar with the use of pulses because my duty in the Naval Reserve during World War II, was to teach shipboard pulse radar and sonar electronics to Navy personnel. So he has great experience in the pulse techniques. Then this phenomena was used in different areas of physics. For example, in in 1958, it was observed the spin echo in electron spin resonance. Then in optics, but I have no pictures. But then next step is the spin echo for neutron. This is a scheme of experiment And this is the difference in the experiment for the NMR and neutrons. This is steps bachelor degree at the Uniata College in 1943. Then Purdue University. In our conference, Nikolai Skrinnikov will participate in the next days, and Nikolai Skrinnikov was graduated from Leningrad State University, and now he works at the Purdue University. In 1947, master degrees. And I told already in 1949, PhD degree. And then he was professor of physics at the Berkeley University, at the system of universities of California, during these years from 55 till 91. And after this, he was Professor Emeritus. Hahn was elected in a different Academy of Science, American Academy of Arts and Sciences, and besides French Academy of Sciences, Fellow of the Royal Society, and Slovenian Academy of Science. Certainly many people think that Erwin Hahn deserves the Nobel Prize for this invention. And for example, Peter Mansfield, this very prominent scientist in the NMR field, said that in his autobiography, that Hahn was the person who was really missed out the Nobel Prize for his contribution to the principles of spin echoes. But Hahn was awarded by gold medal of the International Society for Magnetic Resonance in Medicine and some other. I'd like to show you a few pictures about Hahn. This young Hahn, these children. This is Felix Bloch, and I think he congratulates Hahn at the one of conferences. And this is 1963. I think that you cannot recognize me here. This is Hahn. This is Professor Borodin, and this is interpreter. Some of us about myself. This is my first equipment, which I create in the beginning of 60s. And this is a magnet, which works now in our chair, at our chair. This is my equipment for pulse NMR. And this is an example of the spin echo signals for benzol. Each mark here, 2 seconds. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 9, 11. So this more than 20 seconds decrease of spin echoes and frequency of 180 degree pulses, 250 hertz. I think it's very good result. And certainly this equipment allowed me to create coherent pulses. In the other case, it's impossible to receive such signals. time flies. And 40 years later, this Professor Hahn and me, and certainly, and some other. Hahn played violin, and he delivered lectures about physics of music. It's very interesting. This is Alex Pines. This is certainly Hahn. I think you can recognize it. This is Hartmann. And this is words Alex Pines about Hahn's death. Erwin Hahn, our mentor and dear friend, passed away yesterday. We have lost a giant, and our world will never be the same. On the behalf of our community, we send condolences and love to his wife, Natalie, and family. Alex Pines, a very prominent person in NMR. And this is Hartmann. You know, but many of us know that there is a certain special kind of double resonances, and it is interesting that we can create be effective in the case, for example, two resonances, protons and 13 carbon. We can create frequency in rotating frames, gamma H B1H for the protons, and the other notation frequency for carbon, gamma C B1C. So we applied two signals to applied two signals to protons at proton frequency, and for carbon frequency it is possible to create a condition omega great H is equal omega sub C. In this case, we organize a very strong interaction between two spin systems. And this is the beginning of the double resonances. And this method help to detect carbon resonance, under natural abundance. It was great success, Hartmann. And this is Towns, who create the mother quantum generators. And this is personality of Charles Towns. He died also in a very great age, nearly 100 and 1 year ago. This is Hahn of 90. And this is one of the last photos of Hahn, and I wrote here, we have lost a giant of NMR and physics. Erwin Hahn has passed away 2 months ago at 95 years old. His legacy remains. Also, I have some pictures about this great personality, certainly. But in 2005, special institute for MRI, magnetic resonance imaging, was founded, and this institute received the title after the name of Hahn. Erwin Hahn was alive in the something. It's very interesting. This institute is directed to the development of MRI at ultra high magnetic fields. For example, in label 7 Tesla. And some conclusion. This young and at the age and he plays violin. And this is Professor Lyosha, Dieter here. Dieter, you know this personality from Leipzig, professor. I think he founded NMR in Leipzig. Yes? And my conclusion will be about our team, which helped this conference. St. Petersburg was founded in 1703. St. Petersburg University in 1724. Institute of Physics, 1901. Laboratory of Radio Spectroscopy in the Physical Faculty was founded at 1949. And I'd like to turn your attention that the NMR in condensed matter was observed in 1946, very close to this years. And the Department of Quantum Magnetic Phenomena at 1993, and now we in the big chair which consists from 3 previous chairs, nuclear physics methods of investigation. Our scientific interests are, you can see, we investigate spectra and relaxation in different objects, solids, liquids, liquid crystals, and some others. And we have, I think, interesting experience to detect nuclear magnetic resonance in the Earth magnetic field. The resonance frequency is only 2 kilohertz. It's very difficult to observe, and Pavel Kuprianov created equipment which can work in the laboratory condition, not in the country. Our collective has a few prominent achievements, and the main of them, I think, is linked with the name of Fyodor Skripov. He died at early age, I think, and he realized the first in the world Fourier transform of free induction signals to receive spectra, NMR spectra. and it was published in 1958 in a bulletin of Academy of Sciences of USSR, and this article was translated in English at that times, because this journal was translated in English in that times also. And many years later, Richard Ernst was awarded the Nobel Prize in chemistry in 1991 for his contribution to the development of retransform nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy. And it's very, I think, said that Western scientists never remind the personality of Fyodor Skripov, because it was the first step in this direction. At this slide, I have also two other Nobel laureates for the MRI. And I'd like to relate you that the first suggestion to apply NMR for the imaging was done by Vladislav Ivanov. He was a young lieutenant in that times, and after professor of one of university in Leningrad. He participated at our conferences before 2007. And this is a patent of Ivanov. And you can see in this English version that all important features of MRI was reflected in this. And I'd like to turn your attention that this patent was done in 1984, but priority in 1960. Certainly, it's formal excuse and so on. This is our days. We wrote the book, Magnetic Resonance and Its Applications. It was edited in Springer House, publishing house, and authors Chizhik, Chernyshov, Denis, Frolov, Kamolkin, and Shalapina. Some of this participates in this conference. And now we have about more than 17,000 chapter downloads. And this book in the first quarter of downloads in Springer publishing house. Besides, we wrote a few books in Russian, and some of them I can show you. This is Quantum Radio Physics with subtitle Magnetic Resonance and Its Application. On the basis of this book, we wrote English version in Springer. And this edition of 2009. And the second earlier about relaxation, nuclear magnetic relaxation, it was written by me, 2004, third edition. You can buy some of them at that table. And about our conference, I have a few minutes. This is tree of a group meant of Ampere. Under its auspice, many conferences organizing. And this is our conference, Yov School Conference, Magnetic Resonance and its Applications, PINOS. This school in Poznan, more exactly in Zakopane, annual school. This is a great congress, Euromar, which was organized about 10 years ago, only annual congress and some others. And this last year, you can see some of us here. But sometimes snow was also not only so warm weather as now. So you can see this is snow. The conference begins from welcome. And this is one of our best lecturers, Professor Michel, academician Alexandrov here also, discussions. Spinoz is a school, so we near the blackboard, not black, green board. And this poster section, I turn your attention that is something sometimes somebody thinks about the important features of the posters. Second, and the nearly conclusion of the conference dinner, and awards. You know that Barbara and Uwe Eichhoffs founded the prize 500 euro, and we divided on two parts: 300 euro for best oral presentation and 200. For best poster. And usually there are three nominator of this prize, and he also will receive something. Thank you for your patience. And if you like our conference, please tell everyone about the spinners. Thank you. I think that